Longtime WolfQuest players, or at least longtime viewers of this dev blog, may remember the trouble we had getting the Wolf's IK system to work well. Now, IK is short for Inverse Kinematics. Inverse meaning reverse, the opposite of forward, and kinematics being the mechanics of a chain of objects like bones and joints in a leg or arm. So inverse kinematics means working through that chain of bones and joints to determine how those should be positioned and how they should move relative to each other naturalistically based on what they are interacting with. In our case, that most often means interacting with the ground, but it also means interacting with other animals, like when you're trying to bite an elk. Here's a blast from the past, our dev blog from 2018 about our efforts to get this to work and look good. So inverse kinematics is hard, and inverse kinematics for quadrupeds is really hard, like really, really hard. Back in 2018, one of our programmers at the time went around the huge annual game developer conference one year asking everyone he knew if they'd be interested in tackling a quadruped IK system, and they all said, well, I won't repeat it because this is a family-friendly dev blog, but the gist of it was, no thanks. So we decided to use a software plugin called FinalIK, which is considered the very best IK system available for Unity, but it was designed for bipeds. That developer added some modifications for quadrupeds, which worked well in some ways, but by no means in all the ways that we wanted it to work. But it sufficed. Fortunately, sometime after that, Miko joined our team, and after focusing on multiplayer for a couple years, he then was interested in tackling quadruped IK. And so he's been working on a new system for WolfQuest for a while now. What really prompted this was the fact that using the FinalIK plugin, it's really just two bipeds patched together. So all the animals have something called space legs. They stand perpendicular to whatever surface they're standing on, sort of like they're walking around on the outside of a spaceship. This bugged me. It bugged me a lot. So Miko dove in. You can read his comments on the development of this new IK system in the text below. It's very interesting, gets a little detail, so I'm just going to show a few highlights here. Miko set up this sort of playground to test the IK during development, and here you can see the wolf does a very nice job walking across this, except sometimes kind of gets a little uncertain there and taps its foot. The biting, also quite a challenge, so with these objects that the wolf can latch onto, and then if I move the object around, the wolf really reacts to that and actually tries to kind of brace itself and shift its footing to hold on tightly to maintain a good grip. Of course, as always, you can push these things too far and break them, and so it's always a matter of how far can we let you push it without breaking the mesh. So it was quite a process, but it's in good shape now. Still a few bugs to work out, but mostly working so much better than the old system. So this is how to bite an elk, the 2024 edition, and Miko set up these nice debug graphics to analyze what's happening here when the wolf is doing anything with IK. There's a lot more going on here than I'm going to explain right now, but the orange dots indicate the initial pose before IK does anything, and the yellow shows after it's been adjusted for the ground slope. There's the darker blue boxes that are ray casting to the ground to guide the foot placement. The green dots indicate the final wolf pose after all the IK calculations have been solved. A lot going on here. But not only is it a big improvement, a proper quadruped IK system, but it gives us a nice platform for taking it further and do additional refinements to wolf movement and wolf interactions when we've got some time to dive back into that. So this is coming in the WolfQuest saga, and the saga is coming later this year.